So welcome students in the 8th video of refraction and reflection. In the previous video we had studied about the refraction rules for converging lens, that is convex lens, and the refraction rules for the concave lens, and we had studied how the image is created by convex lenses. In this video we will study about the image formed by the concave lenses. Now when we take the concave lens, first case we are observing that the object is placed at the infinity. When the object is placed infinity, all the rays which are coming from the object, which is considered to be parallel to the principal axis. So as we had studied previously in the rules for the convex concave lens, all the ray which are coming parallel to the principal axis after passing through the concave lens, means after refracting from the concave lens, they are diverging from each other, so they will never meet on the another side on the of the lens. So if we extend all this ray on the same side of the object, you can see that the dotted line meets at the focal point F1. So what we can say about this image is, the image is highly diminished, because you can see that all the rays, they are meeting at focal point F1, so the image is very small, which we can say is a point size image. The image is not real because it is available on the same side of the object, so we cannot see it as a real image, but it is a virtual image, and the image is an erect, that is it gets above the principal axis, but it is very much point size, so we cannot recognize it, but we can get the image at focal point F1. So this is the first case for the concave lens. For the second case, we will take the object between two F1, that is center one of the concave lens, and F1, that is the focal point 1 of the concave lens. When the object is placed between infinity and F1, you can again see that we had taken two different rays to create the image. The first ray we are taking parallel to principal axis, which is after reflecting diverging on the another side, and the second ray we are taking from the point A, which is passing through the optical center O, which is not having any reflection and passing in a straight line. It is indicated in the figure by arrow. Now this two ray on the another side will never meet each other, so what to do? We'll make the extension of the refracted ray on the same side of the object, which is shown by the dotted line in the figure. You can see that this dotted line meets the first ray somewhere between F1 and O. You can see that the image A dash B dash is created between F1 and O. And again from this figure you can see that the size of the image is small, so we can say that the size is diminished. Again we can get the image on the same side as the object is, so image is said to be virtual image, and image is available above the principal axis, so we can say that image is erect. So here there are two cases for the concave lens. Now we'll see the table which shows you the two different cases for concave lens which we had studied in the previous slide. Now sign convention for the spherical lenses. We had already studied about the sign convention for spherical mirrors. So the same rules or similar rules we need to apply for the spherical lenses. We apply the rule for the sign of distance, except that all the measurements are taken from the optical center for the lenses. For the mirror we have a pole in the center. Here for the lenses we have the optical center in the mirror. So in the case of mirror we are measuring the distance from pole. Here in the case of lenses we need to measure the distances from the optical center O. According to the convention, the focal length of the convex lens. Now focal length of the convex lens is taken positive and the focal length of the concave lens is taken as negative. We must take care to apply the appropriate sign that we had studied in the case of mirrors for the values of U, that is object distance, V, that is image distance, and F, that is focal length. We also put the appropriate sign for the object height, that is H, and image height, that is H dash. Kindly refer the slide for the sign convention for spherical mirrors. The similar rules we need to apply for the spherical lenses. Now let us study the lens formula. As we had studied the mirror formula, the similar formula is the lens formula, which relates the object distance U and image distance V to the focal length F of the lens, and which is expressed as 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. In the case of mirror, we have plus sign in between. Here we have minus sign in between. The lens formula above is general, means it is valid in all the situations for any spherical lenses. Now, while putting the value of V, U and F, we need to take the care of the sign of the different quantities according to sign convention while calculating the numerical values for solving the problems related to lenses. The another quantity is magnification. It is again same as we had studied it for the magnification of images through mirror. The magnification produced by a lens is similar to that of the spherical mirrors and is defined as the ratio of height of image and the height of object. It is represented by M. If H is the height of object and H dash is the height of image given by the lens, then the magnification produced by the lens is given by M, that is height of image divided by height of object, which we can say M is equal to H dash upon H. In another way, we can define the magnification produced by the lens, which is related to object distance U and image distance V. The similar relation is given also, M is equal to V divided by U. So we can write magnification M is equal to H dash divided by H or V divided by U. So we can relate these quantities with magnification M. the last topic of this chapter, that is the power of lenses. Now from the vast study of the lens and mirror, we come to know that lens has the ability to converge or diverge the right ray depends on its focal length. For an example, a convex lens of short focal length. Now what is mean by short focal length? When the curvature is very much high, then it has the short focal length. It bends the light ray through a large angle and by focusing them closer to the optical center. Similarly, a concave lens of very short focal length causes the higher divergence than the one with the longer focal length. So here we can measure the degree of convergence and degree of divergence. Degree of convergence and degree of divergence again indicates the amount by which the light ray refracted. So degree of convergence and degree of divergence indicate the amount by which the light ray is refracted and which is represented or expressed in terms of its power. The power of the lens is defined as the reciprocal of its focal length and it is represented by capital letter P. So the power of a lens of focal length F, which is given by P, is equal to 1 upon F. The SI unit of power of a lens is diopter and it is denoted by capital letter D. If we express the focal length F in terms of meter, because length is always measured in terms of meter, so SI unit of length is meter, so power is expressed in terms of diopter. So we can say that one diopter is the power of lens whose focal length is 1 meter. So we can say that one diopter is equal to 1 meter inverse. You may note that the power of lens, convex lens, is positive. Why the power of convex lens is positive? Because the focal length is considered as negative, and that's why the power of focal length is positive. Similarly, the power of concave lens is negative. You had observed that while we are visiting the opticians to prepare our spectacles, the opticians prescribed us the corrective lenses to make a clear images for our eyes, and which are indicated their powers. Let us say that the lens prescribed has the power equal to plus 2D. This means that the prescribed lens is a convex lens and the focal length is plus 0.5 meter. Similarly, a lens of power minus 2.5D has the focal length of minus 0.4 meter and which is the concave lens. So this is how the opticians are prescribing us the lens. We had seen the opticians by putting the different combinations of lenses, and they make us to read the object which is on placed at somewhere distance, and they are slowly come to the conclusion that this is the correct combination of lenses, and then they will prescribing the particular power of the lens. So this is what the end of the chapter 10, that is light and its